In this video, we will be looking at the topic of alloys. An alloy is a mixture of two or more metals, or metal with a non-metal. At least one of the elements must be a metal. Here, element X represents the metal, and element Y is the other element. Examples include steel, which contains iron and carbon, bronze, which contains copper and tin, and brass, which contains copper and zinc. Alloys often have properties that can be very different from the metals they contain. For example, they can have more strength, hardness, or resistance to corrosion or extreme temperatures. These enhanced properties can make alloys more useful than pure metals. For example, aluminium is mixed with copper, manganese, and silicon for aircraft body production, as the alloy is stronger but still has a low density. Remember that an alloy is not a compound. It is a mixture, as the different elements are not chemically bonded together. To understand why alloys are used instead of pure metals, we need to look at their structures. We will use copper as an example, but remember that pure metals all have a similar arrangement of the metal ions. If a force is applied to the regular lattice of a pure metal, the layers can slide over one another, meaning that metals are malleable and ductile. Malleable means the metal can be hammered into shape, and ductile means the metal can be drawn out into a wire. However, if we look at an alloy such as bronze, we can see that the atoms are different sizes, and the regular arrangement of the pure metal has been distorted. This means it is much harder for the layers to slide over one another. If you are asked in a question about the properties of an alloy compared to a pure metal, remember to write down that the atoms in an alloy are different sizes. Let's now have a look at some example exam questions which are about alloys. This question asks you to explain why steel alloys are used in preference to iron. This means that you must give a reason for steel being used instead of iron. We know that alloys have more desirable properties, and we need to compare the two by using words like stronger, harder, or more resistant. Make sure you use these words and compare the two materials for the mark. The second question is asking for a use of stainless steel, which is a common question. Here, you just need to give one use for one mark. Make sure you know at least two uses of each of the alloys you need to be aware of, just in case one is already given in the question. This question comes up a lot, but is given in different contexts. The main point being asked about is why alloys are stronger than pure metals. As we have seen in this video already, we know that the structures are different, and this has an impact on their properties. There are three marks on offer, so 3 points should be made. The question is asking you to make the comparison between a pure metal and an alloy, so you must make reference to both materials. For the first mark, you need to say that pure metals have a regular lattice arrangement, or all the atoms or ions in a pure metal are the same size. For the second mark, you need to say that the alloy contains atoms that are different sizes, and this will disrupt the arrangement of the layers. This means that the layers in an alloy can no longer slide over each other as easily. This will now score you your third mark. In summary, you need to know that an alloy is a mixture of two or more metals, or a metal with a non-metal. Alloys are used instead of pure metals as they are stronger or harder, more resistant to corrosion, and to extreme temperatures. Alloys contain elements of different sizes that distort the regular structure of a pure metal. Don't forget to check out all our other fantastic revision resources here at Save My Exams.